Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to the Most High, our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in the name of His only begotten Son, our Savior, Yahweh Shai. Peace be upon the house of David, which is the elect, by Yahweh Shal Dawada, which is foreknown of Yahweh through Yahweh Shai, sacrifice. I just wanted to do this lesson, Lord willing, to be edifying unto the elect. Just keep pressing towards the mark, you know, just keep fighting, you know, even though, you know, we all gonna fuck up, we all gonna slip, we all gonna, you know, have our shortcomings, man, but we gotta remember that the Lord's grace and mercy, it endures forever, okay, and his love, you know, we have to always keep that in our mind, you know, when we slip and fall, you know, just... We have to, repent, you know, humble ourselves, repent to the Lord, and, you know, sincerely ask for forgiveness and actually believe that He will forgive us, okay? You know, we can't, like the scripture says, let our sins weigh us down, okay? So I'm just going to get into this, Lord willing, to be edifying, you know, to the Akim and Akwaf that are out there, man. Just, you know, the scripture says all sins can be forgiven except the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. So don't think that... your sins is too much for Yahweh Shai's blood, you know. If you're a part of the elect, Yahweh Shai's blood can and will sanctify you, all right? So, and that's a gift from the Most High, you know. That's what we always got to remember, too, that it's a gift from Yahweh, okay, that He sent His Son, Yahweh Shai. So we got to cherish that gift, okay, and we got to literally, you know, show ourselves to be, you know, worthy of that gift, okay? Even though we might fall, you know, we have to continue to keep getting up and keep fighting, okay? Keep pressing towards, you know, that salvation, all right? So this is Isaiah 59:1. It says, behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, neither is His ear heavy that it cannot hear. So right here, man, the scriptures is telling you that the Lord's hand is not too short that He can't save you. All right, you being, you know, Israel, okay, specifically the elect of Israel, you know, which we hope that we are. It says that His hand is not too short that it cannot save, neither is His ear heavy that it cannot hear. So if you sincerely cry unto, you know, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, he will hear you. All right, and if you sincerely ask Him, you know, to forgive you for your trespasses, he will do that. You know, so. But the first thing that we got to do is actually acknowledge our sins and, you know, also, you know, ask for that forgiveness, all right? Scripture says that if you believe with your heart and confess with your mouth, you know, then you have the ability to be delivered, man. And we have to, you know, continually remind ourselves that, man, that we can't get too down on ourselves, because that means that we don't have the faith in Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai that he can deliver us, all right? So this is Psalms chapter 34, verse 17. It says, the righteous cry, and Yahweh heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh to them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. So the righteous are going to cry unto the Lord, man, and He's going to hear them. Because those are His children, all right? Scripture says that you are God's, and you are all the children of the Most High, all right? So if you got that earnest, you know, and that spirit, you know, in you, don't let your sins, you know, weigh you down, man. Don't fall into mischief, like Scripture says. You know, the righteous fall seven times, but he gets back up again. But the wicked fall into mischief. You know, that's when you fall into mischief, man, then you just start going down that road of perdition. You know, you used to start, like how they try to say in the world that, like, smoking weed is the gateway drug. You know, then you just end up going to different drugs. You know, you're not supposed to go down that road, man. You know, you're supposed to realize, you know, I'm fucking up, you know. I'm fucking up. I got to get these, you know, these Satan fucking with me. I got to get these demons off of me. All right, and you sincerely cry unto Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, and He will hear you. He'll hear you and heal you. All right, and it says He will deliver you out of all them troubles, because the troubles is not just, you know, physical. All right, you could be having troubles, you know, spirits plaguing you in your mind, okay? Demons fucking with you, you know, certain wicked evil thoughts, you know, that is trying to manifest, you know, into your life. You know, you got to rebuke that spirit, you know? You got to cry, sincerely crying to the Lord, man, you know? Fall on your face and sincerely asking, you know, Yahweh Bashem Yahushua to deliver you. And we just read that, what? That his ear is not too heavy, that he cannot hear. All right. And he said, the Lord is nigh to them that are of a broken heart. All right. So you got to come brokenhearted unto the Lord. You can't come boasting. You can't come humbled and puffed up, man. The Lord's not dealing with those type of individuals. You know, even King David, man, him being a king, well, he was a man after the Most High's mind, but he still was in the flesh and he still fucked up, you know, and he still, you know, committed a sin that was worthy of death. But because he had a broken heart and a contrite spirit, the Lord was nigh unto him. And the Lord didn't, you know, impute that sin unto him, all right? So the scriptures gives you an example of where the Lord can save you. He can forgive you, you know, from even the worst of sins, man, all right? Just like how he did with King David. You know, verse 19, it says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but Yahweh delivereth him out of them all. So we're going to go through many afflictions, man. This is evident. You're not going to come into this truth and not go through afflictions. You, matter of fact, you're going to go through more afflictions, all right? You're going to have more demons trying to fuck with you. Why? Because the scripture says that the devil goes around like a lion seeking whom he may devour. He's not going to devour, you know, two-thirds. They're already devoured. They're already, you know, they're already caught up in his snare. He's trying to get the ones that are of the righteous, you know, that aren't caught up. So we're going to have to suffer many afflictions. But it says, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai delivereth him out of them all of them, man. Every single one of our afflictions, the Lord is going to send that necessary strength, you know, to keep fighting in his journey, man. You know, we just got to have that faith in the Lord that he won't. That he won't forsake us, man. That he won't leave us. That he will, you know, deliver us out of all of our troubles. Okay, so I'm gonna get this next scripture. This Shalaki. I'm trying to find it real quick. This is I just get Proverbs. Shalak. It's Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16. It says, for a just man falleth seven times and rises up again, but the wicked shall fall into mischief. Yeah, so, you know, a just man is going to fall. You know, those are those afflictions, all right? But what? They're not going to let those afflictions overtake them. You know, that's the key right there. Don't let those afflictions, you know, overtake you. And then now you at the point of now you just, you know, out there in the world just being a reprobate, man. You know, you don't want to get to that point where, you know, you just don't even seek the Lord anymore. You know, don't even call upon him. You know, that's when you fall into mischief. But what? A just man's going to fall seven times, and seven means completion. But he's going to get up again. That's what makes him just, is the fact that he's continually still fighting, man, that he's still trying to please the Lord no matter what happens to him. No matter what sins he might have committed, no matter, how hard he fell, the fact that he gets up again, that's what makes him just, all right? So this is Isaiah 55 and 6. Says, seek ye Yahweh while he may be found, call upon him while he is near. So the Lord is still able to be found in these times because we're still here, all right? You know, the word is still going out. So if the word of the Lord is still going out, that means he's still able to be found. He still may be found. As long as his word is being pushed out throughout the four corners of the earth, you still have an opportunity to be delivered by Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, all right? And only he's only going to deliver that elect, but hey, you could possibly be that elect, man. The Lord, you know, he deals with the lowly and the meek, okay? Yahweh Shah said he didn't come for the whole. He came for the ones that are sick. All right, the ones that are sick. You just had a what? Knocking, and the door should be open unto you. Seek and ye shall find. Okay, so that's what you gotta always remember, man. That no matter what, you in this truth, you know, keep fighting. If you fall, get up again. All right. That the thing that the Yahweh hates, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai hates the most is if you fall and you quit, man. Lord don't want no quitters, man. He don't want nobody that let their sin overtake them. Yahweh Shai said that the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. So you gotta gird up your loins. You gotta gird up your loins of your mind and keep fighting, man. Keep moving until the end, until your last breath, or until the day of the Lord, man. And hopefully that you get delivered. Hey, what did I pull that last scripture up, man? What did Job say? I believe it's in Shalaki, I'm trying to find the scripture real quick. Job said, what? Though he slay me, you know, yet shall I maintain my trust in him. So that's the mentality that we got to have, man. Though the Lord slay us, even if the Lord slay us, we still got to maintain our trust in the Lord, man. We still got to say, you know what? Hey, if that be the case, you know, I'm still following in Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shah. I'm still going to seek after him, even if he slays me. You know, I'm trying to see if I can find that scripture. There you go. Job 13 and 15. It says, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him, but I will maintain my own ways before him. So what? You know what the ways of the Lord are, man. You know what the Lord requires you to do, you know, and requires you not to do. So even if the Lord destroys you, even if you see you at the lowest point that the Lord ain't dealing with you, or you know you just keep getting in hell after hell, you keep falling, you know, you keep slipping. Scripture says be like Job, man. Though he slay me, yet I will still trust in him. You're still supposed to trust in Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. You're still supposed to believe his word. You're still supposed to follow, you know, what he told you to do. Okay, even if it's to the point where the Lord ain't even dealing with you, say, you know what? Hey, you know this is the truth. You know this gospel is the true gospel. Then so be it. All right, to have that mentality. Even if the Lord is going to kill me and I'm gonna be, you know, I ain't gonna be delivered. I'm gonna still go out there and proclaim this word. I'm still going out there and believe that this is the truth. Believe that Yahweh sent Yahweh Shai as our savior, man. All right, and that there's no other way to Yahweh except through Yahweh Shai. You still gotta believe that, man. All right, and what? Just like we said, that the Lord he will deliver you, man. All right, because you maintain that faith in him. Scripture says that without faith, it's impossible to please the Lord, man. So you still, through everything you go through, you gotta have that faith in Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. All right, so you know, Lord willing, this was edifying. Just had this on my mind, so wanted to get that out there. You know. Out there to the sheep, man. Lord willing, it's edifying, you know. So all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, and keep fighting. Shalom.